And some breaking developments now coming in. This is CNN News 18's exclusive. We have accessed the remand note of SHO Abhijeet Mondal. CBI in its remand note has mentioned that Abhijeet Mondal hatched a criminal conspiracy with other probable accused person in screening like Sanjay Roy and others, trying to divert the direction of investigation as well. What we are also learning is that OCG Abhijeet Mondal reached the scene of crime at 11 a.m., which is 1 hour after receiving the information. CNN News 18's editor is Kamalika Sen Gupta is also joining us on the phone line. Kamalika, very good morning to you. Since we have exclusively accessed this remand note of SHO Abhijeet Mondal, what exactly can be inferred from the highlights of this remand note?
See, this is the exact logic which the CBI has put in court yesterday. CBI has stated in the court that at around 10:03, the Tala Thana OC Abhijeet Mondal, he came to know about this incident. But he reached in the incident area, the point of occurrence, at around 11 p.m. It is stated that knowing that it is a case of a woman doctor who has died, and there might be such things happening, and why he took 1 hour late to reach there, number one. Number two, at around 10, he had spoken to Sandeep Ghosh. And after 10 in the morning, they came to know. And the FIR time was after 11 p.m. at night. Why after 14 hours this FIR was lodged? And the CBI believes that there might be a nexus. This might be a part of a larger conspiracy. And that is why they want to take Abhijeet Mondal into custody. And 3-day custody has been given. And apart from that, also, there are several questions that has been raised in remand note that the family wanted a second PM postmortem, which was not allowed. And a lot of other things like there was written that an unconscious body. You know, what is an unconscious body? When it is a place where all the doctors are there, why unconscious thing was written when it was known that the person has died? So there are 10 to 11 points which the CBI has raised, where the CBI feels that this is a part of a big nexus and a larger conspiracy, and has also mentioned that being a responsible OC, he should have taken much more steps in this case, which he has not taken, and that is why it is important to keep him in custody and then talk to and get the larger conspiracy theory out.
Right, Kamalika, thank you so much for putting all of that into perspective for our viewers. In fact, we just spoke of the remand note of Abhijeet Mondal, but apart from that, we have also exclusively received the CBI remand note of accused Sandeep Ghosh in this case as well. CBI has informed the court that CFSL report of the polygraph test states that Sandeep Ghosh deliberately tried to deceive the investigators on some important issues, and Sandeep Ghosh did not intend to register an FIR in this particular matter even after he got the information at around 9:58 a.m. He did not reach the college immediately as well. CNN News 18's Anshul Singh is also joining us on the broadcast. Anshul, a very good morning to you. What can actually be decoded through this remand copy of Sandeep Ghosh as well? Also, if you could help us break this entire association between Sandeep Ghosh, Abhijeet Mondal, as well as Sanjay Roy, what triangular connection are we here decoding to our viewers?
Well, the CBI in its investigation has found, and it has reasons to believe, that there was a conspiracy that was hatched between Sandeep Ghosh and the SHO of Thala Police Station, that is Abhijeet Mondal, to somewhere or the other go ahead and save the accused Sanjay Roy from actually going behind the bars. What we have accessed the remand note that was presented in front of the court yesterday, where the Central Bureau of Investigation have in fact gone ahead and narrated how there was a deliberate attempt that was made by the SHO or the officer in charge of Thala Police Station, Abhijeet Mondal, to actually go ahead and somewhere or the other destroy evidences that were present on the spot. The manner in which the evidences were collected from the spot, that was not videographed, which is against the mandate of the BNSS, because according to the BNSS, whenever evidence is procured from the scene of crime, it has to be videographed, and that was not done in the right manner. Apart from this, Abhijit Mandal also somewhere or the other tried to divert attention from the main accused Sandeep Ghosh, and he also eventually tried to build some sort of a pressure on the family, in which he decided to go, in which he asked them to do the cremation in a hurried manner, where the family had in fact asked them for a second test as well. But apart from this, also the Central Bureau of Investigation has reasons to believe that Sandeep Ghosh tried to downplay the entire situation. Even after we got to know about the incident on that very morning, he got in contact with the SHO of Abhijit Mandal, right, and also an advocate, and even in this contact, he somewhere or the other tried to divert the attention and tried to make sure that the case of rape is not registered. It is only.
Yeah, right. Thank you so much, Anshul, for putting all of that into perspective for our viewers. Apologies, that's all the time that we have on that story. But right now, we have got some more breaking news now coming in with regards to the same.